Today we are here to discuss the efficiency scan. The efficiency scan deals with the efficiency in filtering companies based on their account receivables, account payables, inventories and working capital requirement. If a company is efficient, it can stay afloat for a longer period of time. A company with a well-balanced payments and receivables performance can generate good cash flow and hence grow well. Thus, one should monitor this closely to understand the company's financial strength. To know all about your company's efficiency, we have the StockEdge app for your rescue. Click on Scans, then on the Fundamental Scans, and there you have the Efficiency Scan. Now, the efficiency scans, you will see accounts receivables, which deals with the payments that a company has to receive against its services rendered or products sold to the clients, which means the credit the client owes. Increased days of receivable means that debtors are taking more time to repay for the goods consumed, thus increasing working capital requirement, which puts stress in the company's books. It can also create liquidity crunch for the company, which is negative for cash flow generation. Decreased days of receivables means that the debtors are making the payments as per the specified time frame, thereby reducing the need for working capital requirement, which is a healthy sign for the company's books. It also means that the sales to turnover ratio is good for the company, thus liquidity under these circumstances to be beneficial for the cash flow of the company. Now, account payable means that the payment that the company has to render against it credits. Inventories take into account the goods remaining with the company after the end of the quarter or the year. Increased days of payables means that the company is taking longer time to repay for the goods purchased on credits from its suppliers, which sends a negative sign about the company's liquidity position. It means that the company does not have the required cash flow to meet its short-term debt obligations. Decreased days of payable means that the company's liquidity is strong, thus it is able to repay its creditors. It also means that the company has the ability to fulfill its short-term debt obligations. Thus, one should monitor this closely to understand the company's financial strength. Now, in what does inventories mean? Inventories are those which could not be turned into sales as did not get processed into finished products by the end of the year. Increased days of inventories mean that the company is unable to convert its goods into sales as it has purchased more than it can sell. Thus, the cash flow is impacted negatively if inventory turnover ratio increases. It raises concern about the company's ability to convert its inventory to sales if the inventory turnover ratios continues to increase. Decreased days of inventory means that the demand for the product is so robust that the company is able to convert its inventory into sales, and thus decreasing inventory turnover ratio and hence increasing earning as well as the cash flow. Working capital is the short-term component required to run the daily requirements of a business, from purchasing of inventory to the sales of goods. Thus, in practical terms, it means the capital required to fuel the short-term requirement of the company. Increased days of working capital means that the company is taking time to generate cash from its inventory to sales cycle, which is negative for the growth of the company, as the cash flow generation cycle will be slow, and hence the working capital requirement will have to be funded through debt financing. Decreased days of working capital means that the company is able to liquidate its inventory to cash. Thus, the working capital requirement is funded through internal accruals only and debt financing is not required. These types of companies can efficiently manage its day-to-day operations and generate free cash flow for the company. If you want to know more about the efficiency scan or its various formulas, then you can log on to blog.stockedge.com. Thank you.